Section 28. Sauti said, Garuda, thus addressed by the snakes, then said unto his mother, I shall go to bring amrita. I desire to eat something in the way. Direct me to it, Vinata replied. In a remote region in the midst of the ocean, the Nishadas have their fair home. Having eaten the thousands of Nishadas that live there, bring thou amrita. But let not thy heart be ever set on taking the life of a Brahmana. Of all creatures, a Brahmana must not be slain. He is indeed like fire. A Brahmana, when angry, becomes like fire or the sun, like poison or an edged weapon. A Brahmana, it has been said, is the master of all creatures. For these and other reasons, a Brahmana is the adored of the virtuous, whose child is never to be slain by thee even in anger. Hostility with Brahmanas, therefore, would not be proper under any circumstances. O sinless one, neither Agni nor Surya truly can consume so much as does a Brahmana of rigid vows when angry. By these various indications, must thou know a good Brahmana. Indeed, a Brahmana is the firstborn of all creatures, the foremost of the four orders, the father and the master of all. Garuda then asked, O mother, of what form is a Brahmana, of what behavior, and of what prowess? Doth he shine like fire, or is he of tranquilly mien? And O mother, it behoveth thee to tell my inquiring self those auspicious signs by which I may recognize a Brahmana. Vinata replied, saying, O child, him should thou know as the best amongst Brahmanas who, having entered thy throat, would torture thee as a fish hook, or burn thee as blazing charcoal. A Brahmana must never be slain by thee even in anger. And Vinata, out of affection for her son, again told him these words, him shouldst thou know as a good Brahmana who would not be digested in thy stomach. Although she knew the incomparable strength of her son, yet she blessed him heartily for deceived by the snakes. She was very much afflicted by hope, and she said, let Marut, the god of the winds, protect thy wings, and Surya and Soma, thy vertebral regions. Let Agni protect thy head, and the Vasus, thy whole body. I also, O child, engage in beneficial ceremonies, shall sit here for your welfare. Go then, O child, in safety to accomplish thy purpose. Sauti continued. Then Garuda, having heard the words of his mother, stretched his wings and ascended the skies, and endued with great strength, he soon fell upon the Nishadas, hungry and like another Yama, and went upon slaying the Nishadas. He raised a great quantity of dust and overspread the firmament, and sucking up water from amid the ocean, shook the trees growing on the adjacent mountains, and then that lord of birds obstructed the principal thoroughfares of the town of Nishadas by his mouth, increasing its cleft at will. And the Nishadas began to fly in great haste in the direction of the open mouth of the great serpent eater, and as birds in great affliction ascend by thousands into the skies, and the trees in the forest are shaken by the winds, so those Nishadas, blinded by the dust raised by the storm, entered the wide extending cleft of Garuda's mouth open to receive them. And then the hungry lord of all rangers of the skies, that oppressor of enemies, endued with great strength and moving with the greatest celerity to achieve his end, closed his mouth, killing innumerable Visharas, following the occupation of fishermen. So ends the 28th section in the Astika Parva of the Adi Parva.